So this is the strategy that I'm going to code for you today. The strategy is based on absolute momentum, which momentum is probably the most well-documented market anomaly. There's some research there that I've referenced that I recommend you check out if you're not familiar with it. The strategy that we'll trade today uses what's called absolute momentum, which is essentially the momentum of a single asset price itself over some formation period. It's simply the price at the current period minus the price some time ago, and that time is the formation period. And the trading logic based on this strategy is we go long if absolute momentum is greater than zero. Otherwise, we hold a short position. And there's only one parameter in this whole strategy, and that's the formation period, F, or how far back do we look in the past to calculate momentum. So I'm going to switch over to a Zorro environment now and code this strategy for you. We'll end up with a complete strategy in around 15 to 20 lines of code. And we'll also have a look at some at the equity curve and some performance statistics. So here's my Zorro interface, and here's the skeleton of this strategy that I'm going to code for you. The way Zorro simulations work is that they run in a essentially a giant loop. So the script, the code that we write, will get executed every time. Every time one bar closes and a new one opens. So the first thing we want to do is provide some parameters that control the setup of the strategy. So things like the start date of the strategy in year, month, day format. Likewise, the end date. And look, no doubt the syntax here is going to look a little bit like gibberish to many of you who've never seen this sort of coding before, but please, I just ask you to take a leap of faith with me at the moment and just go through the process, and hopefully you'll see how simple it can be to research in this environment, and also how powerful the tool can be as well. So in addition to the start and end date, we also need a bar period. Bar period is measured in minutes, so we're going to set our bar period at 1440, which corresponds to a full day. And we also need a look-back period, which I'll come back to this parameter in a moment. So one of the strengths of this Zorro tool is that I mentioned that the nuts and the bolts of the simulation is really abstracted from the user, which enables you to focus on the research and the development itself. There's a really neat way that Zorro handles time series, and this line of code will create a series of closing prices stretching back as far back as the look back period. So that close object there, that now contains 160 previous closing prices, and so that little line of code there is actually accomplishing quite a lot. The other thing we need for our momentum strategy is the formation period, which we're going to provide as a parameter. And to do that, we might do something like this. I'm going to start with a formation period of 80 days, and we'll probably change that and have a look at some others as well. In order to actually do the momentum calculation, we can use a function that that Zorro has built into it, and that little calculation looks like this. Which is really nice. Zorro does all with that little function, mom function. Zorro does all the heavy lifting for us. And besides that function, there is a huge range of technical, statistical, machine learning, signal processing functions that are built into Zorro, which makes it really, really super efficient to use. And of course, you can also write your own functions. So in those few lines of code there, we've set up our simulation. We've got all the data we need, and we've done all the calculations that we need in order to generate some trading signals. So what's missing is our trading logic. So in this example, we're going to hold a long position when our momentum is positive, and a short position when it's negative. And as you'll see, that is really easy to implement as well. So that's our trading logic right there, two lines of code. We're also going to set up some plot commands so that we can see an equity curve, and we can also have a look at this absolute momentum as an indicator style plot. So in order to do that, I'll use this plot function. I'm also going to adjust how the plot actually looks on our screen. And that's pretty much it. That's our trading strategy right there. Of course, if you've never seen C programming, this is a subset of the C language, I guess. But if you've never seen C code before, then everything I coded here probably looks like gibberish. But the point is that it's quite simple, and it requires surprisingly few lines of code to write a script for an idea that you can then test and simulate. So in order to test our strategy, we go to the Zorro GUI. We select the strategy that we just wrote, and we simply click the test button. And now, if I haven't made any errors, the simulation will run. We get some output in the window and some performance statistics. And if I click the result button, I'm going to get firstly a more detailed performance report with a whole bunch of statistics. And I'm also going to get this visual output. Which there's a fair bit going on here, so I'll just explain what we're looking at here. The black line in the chart is is actually the price curve of the underlying market that we're trading, in this case the euro dollar spot market. The blue line that we see is the equity that the strategy has accumulated, and the red curve that we see is a drawdown of the strategy. And in the window underneath all of that is the absolute momentum indicator plotted. Also in the main window, we've got the green lines represent winning trades, and red lines represent losing trades. So we get quite a bit of feedback on our idea very, very quickly. In reality, you'll find that using this plotting function in Zorro is actually a little bit limited, but this is one feature that's undergoing a huge upgrade in version 2, and I know that the developers are going to release some interactive plotting functionality and just make this feature a lot more beautiful. So we'll also just have another quick look at the textual output. There's a whole bunch of detailed information here that I won't go over. Too much now, but I'll leave that for you to look at your leisure. But now that we've got our basic strategy and we've got a little bit of feedback, I want to show you some of Zorro's power. For instance, we can quickly run this strategy for various values of the formation period. So by simply changing this formation period to say 40, I can get some feedback on how that would affect the strategy. You can see there I've got a different result altogether. a very different equity curve. If I use a longer formation period, 150 days in this case, and click test, I get some more feedback. Again, a very different equity curve. Another thing we can do very quickly with Zorro is to test our strategy on some different markets as well. So at the moment, we've selected the Euro US dollar spot market to run our strategy on, but we can just as easily ask it to simulate how the strategy would have performed on the pound dollar market, maybe dollar yen as well. Let's throw the Aussie in there for good measure. So all obviously very different performance depending on the asset that we chose. So I'm just going to go back and select the Euro again. Now another really powerful feature of Zorro is that as well as looking at individual single markets, we can run this strategy for a portfolio of assets, and that's done with quite a simple line of code that I'll just put up here. So that simple line of code there, while I'm sure it looks like gibberish if you've never seen this before, is actually accomplishing a great deal. It's running this trading logic for each of these four instruments at every bar. So we've just gone from having a single instrument strategy to now we have a portfolio strategy. And if we simulate that, now we get our equity curve represents the equity of the entire portfolio, while the black price curve represents the price curve of the asset that was selected in the scroll box, the euro dollar in this case. But the equity curve is the curve of the entire portfolio. So that's a really powerful feature of Zorro, that you can do portfolio simulations so readily. But I'm just going to go back to our original script. The next thing I want to show you is parameter optimization. So this strategy depends on a single parameter F, or formation period rather. And we briefly looked at how the performance of the strategy varies across a few different values of that formation period. But the obvious question arises is there an optimal value, pardon me, and can we find it? To do that sort of analysis, Zorro has a powerful parameter optimization engine that's built in. So I'm just going to briefly show you how that works. So the first thing I need to do is this line of code, which puts Zorro into optimization mode. And now I replace the value of my formation period with Zorro's optimize function. And the optimize function needs a default value, which we'll use our original value. It also needs a range of values that we want to test. In this case, we'll test everything from 40 to 150. And it also needs a step size. And I'm going to make that step size 10. So in this case, Zorro will test every value between 40 and 150, incrementing by 10, so 40, 50, 60, etc. And so in order to run this optimization, we simply click the train button instead of the test button. You'll see Zorro run through a bunch of simulations, one for each parameter of interest. We'll go through and it'll tell us that if we round up to 100, we get the best performance here measured as profit factor, by the way. So I've got my my optimal parameter there, which I'll now go back and plug into here as my formation period, and I'm going to re-simulate that. And there's my new equity curve with my optimal parameter over that data set. But the thing is, anyone who's done any trading systems development will tell you that selecting the best parameter from a training run gives you absolutely no assurance that it'll be the best parameter in the future. In fact, it's pretty likely that it won't be the best parameter in the future. This problem is referred to as overfitting, selecting a parameter on the basis of its past performance, and that can lead to some really suboptimal decision making. So what we really need to justify the selection of that parameter is an unseen data set, which we can then test it on to draw our conclusions. That's pretty easy to do in Zorro. We simply change the start and end date of our simulation in order to give us an out of sample period. But I want to show you something a little bit more powerful today. So I want to show you something called walk-forward analysis, which many of you are probably familiar with. But a single out-of-sample test is rarely the best way to analyze a parameter. There's a problem that we only have one out-of-sample or clean data set, and if we keep on iterating our parameters and looking at the out-of-sample performance until we find something that works, we'll eventually find one that does. And that process is called data mining bias, and just like curve fitting, it can lead to some really poor decisions. And there's a few ways to deal with that problem, but one of the ways involves getting a little bit more feedback by using walk-forward analysis. And walk-forward is essentially a periodic re-optimization. You break your entire data set up into regular intervals, and then split those intervals into training and test sets, ultimately stringing together all of the out-of-sample periods, which results in a dynamic out-of-sample test. Really useful tool. Obviously, it's not the be-all and end-all, but it is a great tool. And we can implement it in Zorro simply with this line of code. So now I'm telling Zorro to split my simulation data into 10 walk-forward cycles. And when I hit train now, oops, hang on, I need to tell Zorro what to optimize. And now if I hit train, you'll see that Zorro will go through that training process a total of 10 times. As it's doing this, it's saving what it thinks are the best parameters for each out-of-sample period. And then when this is finished running, I'll test it. And Zorro is smart enough to be able to string together the correct parameter or the selected parameter and line that up with the correct data period as well. So these are our walk-forward results for this strategy, and that's what our equity curve looks like. So you can see that the length of the back test is shortened somewhat, and that's because we lose some data at the front end of the simulation when we do walk-forward. But it's a more robust way to measure the performance of your trading strategy. But the point here was really I just wanted to show you how simple it is to implement what is actually quite a complex process in Zorro.